Good day, children! Welcome to another fun-filled and insightful session of learning mathematics. I am Teacher Levy Jun, your teacher in Mathematics 6, and I will guide you in sharpening and enhancing your knowledge about the exponential notation. Are you excited? I am too! Let's have a wonderful day of learning! I have here a mathematical problem, and let's try to read and understand this together. Suppose the virus spreads to 2 persons in 1 hour. How many individuals will be affected in 4 hours? In 7 hours? Let's try to analyze and understand it by answering these questions. What is asked in the problem? What are the given facts? Before answering these questions, always remember to wash your hands often and practice social distancing to help stop the spread of COVID-19. So what is asked in the problem? The number of individuals that will be affected by the virus. What are the given facts? 2 persons, 1 hour, 4 hours, and 7 hours. After analyzing the given problem, let's try to solve the problem. In 1 hour, 2 individuals were affected. So, it's 2. In 2 hours, the number of individuals was doubled. It became 2 times 2. In 3 hours, the number of individuals has doubled again. So it's 2 times 2 times 2. In 4 hours, the number of individuals has also doubled. So it's 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. To answer the first question of the problem, we need to multiply 2 individuals 4 times. So 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 is equal to 16. Therefore, 16 individuals were affected by the virus in 4 hours. To answer the second question, we need to do the same procedure. Multiply the 2 individuals 7 times. So it's 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 and times 2. It's too long, right? To write it easily, or to make it short and simple, the exponential notation will help us. Anyway, what is an exponential notation? Exponential notation, or exponential form, is an easier method or way of writing a number as a product of many factors. Example, this number here is an exponential notation. It's 2 raised to the 7th power. It has 2 parts. This number 2 is the base, and 7 is the exponent. Base is the number used as a factor, or the number multiplied by itself. Exponent tells us how many times the base is used as a factor, or the number of times it is multiplied by itself. I have here an expanded form wherein 2 is multiplied by itself 7 times. You can write 2 raised to the 7th power as its exponential form. So, going back to the mathematical problem earlier, this is the answer to the second question. Therefore, 128 individuals were affected by the virus in 7 days. We get the answer by multiplying 2 by itself 7 times. Now, let's practice how to write exponential notation based on the given expanded form. In this expanded form, what number is multiplied by itself several times? Correct! It's 4. So, 4 is our base. Now, let's count how many 4 in the expanded form. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 is our exponent. So this is 4 raised to the 6th power. How about this expanded form? What number is multiplied by itself several times? That's right, it's 13. Let's count how many 13. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 13s, meaning the exponent is 4. That's right. And how are we going to read this? It's 13 raised to the 4th power. Let's move to this expanded form. What number is multiplied by itself several times? Correct, it's 7. So 7 is our base. Let's count how many 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Meaning, our exponent is also 7. How are we going to read this one? It's 7 raised to the 7th power. Let's move to the next expanded form. What number is multiplied by itself several times? Correct. So 4 is our base. Let's count how many 4s. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 is our exponent. Let's read this one. 4 raised to the 5th power. Let's move to the last expanded form. What number is being multiplied by itself several times? It's 9. So 9 is our base. Let's count how many 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the exponent is 6. So it is 9 raised to the 6th power. This is how are we going to read exponential notation. This is how are we going to read exponential notation. Since 2 is the base, 6 is the exponent, we can read it this way. 2 raised to the 6th power. Just follow the format. Say the base number first, plus the word raised to the, then the exponent number in ordinal form, or plus th, and lastly, the word power. So again, how are we going to read this exponential form? 2 raised to the 6th power. Very good. In this second example, 8 is the base and 4 is the exponent. So we can read this as 8 raised to the 4th power. Again, how will we read this one? Very good. How about this? 3 is the base, 5 is the exponent. How will we read this one? Correct. 3 raised to the 5th power. Let's have these examples. How are we going to read this exponential notation? That's right. It's 11 raised to the 7th power. How about this? Very good. It's 3 raised to the 9th power. Can you name this one? That's right. It's 6 raised to the 9th power. How about this? Very good. It's 7 raised to the 5th power. This one, that's right, it's 5 raised to the 8th power. Pay attention to these reminders. If the exponent is to the 2nd power, you can also read it as squared. If the exponent is to the 3rd power, you can also read it as cubed. Example: this is 10 to the 2nd power or 10 squared. And this is 15 to the 3rd power or 15 cubed. Did you learn something from our lesson today? That's good to hear. I'm sure that you can answer our activity. Write the following expanded forms to exponential notation. I will give you 10 seconds each item to write your answer. What is your answer in number 1? Very good. It's 5 raised to the 7th power. How about number 2? Correct. It's 7 raised to the 11th power. Let's move to item number 3. That's right. It's 4 raised to the 4th power. Number 4, please. Yes, it's 10 raised to the 8th power. And lastly, number 5. Very good. It's 8 raised to the second power or 8 squared. I hope you have learned a lot from today's lesson. Just remember that exponential notation is an easier method or way of writing a number as a product of many factors. Just like these examples. Exponent tells us how many times the base is used as a factor or the number of times it is multiplied by itself. So this is the exponent. A base is a number used as a factor or the number multiplied by itself. This is the base. So before I will end this video lesson, let us answer this activity. Read each question and choose the letter of the correct answer. Number 1. In exponent 16 raised to the 4th power, the 16 represents the blank. A. Base, B. Exponent, C. Value, or D. Number. Correct. It's letter A, base. Second question. In exponent 5 raised to the 9th power, 5 is the base and 9 is the blank. A. Value, B. Number, C. Exponent, or D. Base. Correct. C is the answer. Exponent. 3. Write 15 times 15 times 15 times 15 times 15 in exponential notation or exponential form. That's right. The answer is letter B, 15 raised to the 5th power. Number 4. 9 raised to the 4th power can also be written as blank. Very good. The answer is letter D. Its expanded form is 9 times 9 times 9 times 9. Last number. The expression 14 times 14 times 14 times 14 times 14 times 14 can also be expressed as blank. Correct. It's letter B, 14 raised to the 6th power. Thank you for spending your time in listening to my discussion. Once again, this is Teacher Levy June, your teacher in Mathematics 6. Till our next day of learning, see you! Bye!